So called Kolmogorov complexity gives us an interesting way to think about randomness. It's certainly a useful notion in many areas of computer science, but it's not going to give us a practical way to tell if a sequence is random. It won't even give us a theoretical way to do that because it's uncomputable. The next thing we might think about trying is statistical tests. And this is in fact often used as part of an argument that something produces random numbers. And it should be part of that argument, but it can never be the whole argument. That the only thing we can do with a statistical test is show that something is non-random. We can't ever prove that it is random. We could always find some non-random sequence that satisfies all of our statistical tests. So we're left with our best argument is how the sequence is actually generated. If we know how the sequence is produced, we could have some confidence that it satisfies the randomness requirements we have, at least for generating a good key. And the real requirement there is unpredictability, that we want to know if our sequence is a sequence of numbers like this, where each xi is from the range 0 to 2 to the n minus 1, that even an attacker who's seen the first m numbers in the sequence can only guess the next one with the same probability they would have if they were just guessing by chance. Only 1 out of 2, 2 to the n, the size of the elements in the sequence. So that's the property we want. If we're going to get that property, and we can't do it by using Kolmogorov complexity, because that's uncomputable, we can't do it with statistical tests, because they can only show non-randomness, the way we're going to try to achieve that is by generating the sequence in a way that produces values that are unpredictable to the attacker.